The police are generally in the eye of the storm, for better or for worse. It is one of the government departments which is under serious scrutiny most of the time. Welcome to Guest Editor. Today, to discuss issues surrounding the Goa Police, we have Mr. Muktesh Chandar, who has a PhD from IIT Delhi in cyber security. He's an engineer, he's also a degree in law, a diploma in cyber security. And before coming to Goa, he has been a special commissioner to Delhi Traffic Police. He is not new to Goa. Therefore, I wish to welcome him again to Goa. Welcome to Guest Editor.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
First of all, my general question to you is, knowing the terrain, having understood the politics of the place and the kind of problems that we encounter, what are your general plans for Goa in terms of security or surveillance?
I have served in Goa earlier also for 3 years, and I know Goa Police, I know the terrain, I know the general problems. But one difference in the last 10 years I have found is that there are issues related to traffic. Almost 25% of the cases we book in IPC are related to traffic accidents.
Okay.
And as compared to about 30 murders in Goa in 1 year, we have got more than 250 deaths in road accidents.
Okay.
And out of them, about 40% are self accidents. So there is a serious work required to be done towards road safety issues, and not only by the road users but also by the road owning agencies. A lot of work has to be done, and I am working towards this, in this direction, so as to if we work systematically, we should be able to reduce the number of deaths. That is number one priority.
Yeah.
The other thing I have been noticing is that a lot of financial frauds are taking place.
Okay.
And the recent one is Kamakshi foreign exchange fraud. Apart from that, a lot of ATM and debit card related frauds are also taking place in Goa.
Okay.
This can be curbed only by education, although a lot of cases have been registered, a lot of people have been arrested. But the money once lost is very difficult to recover because of various reasons. If proper education and awareness about traffic issues and about the financial frauds is given to the public, lot of such cases can be reduced.
Now, in case of both these cases, whether it is traffic or it is to do with financial fraud, do you feel the need for where is the lacuna? Is it in terms of the law framework, the policy framework, or is it in terms of putting more men on the ground, having more surveillance, or what is required?
See, men are there, investigation is done, but the difficulty is that it is very clear that you should never reveal your ATM one-time password and the other details like CVV number at the back of your car to anyone. And still people entertain calls. Somebody can say, I am from State Bank of India, tell me your credit card number, tell me your CVV, tell me this, tell me your OTP, and the money is taken out.
So,
and these people who are committing such crimes are sitting anywhere in the country. They could be anywhere in the country. Many calls are coming from Bihar, Jharkhand, Delhi and other places, and the money is diverted to so many accounts. And the investigating officer has to virtually run over entire country in search of these accused. So the best possible way is prevention.
Okay. Now, coming to crime as such, which is the main preoccupation of the police. You would have seen from your last term till now that there has been a rapid increase in the rate of crime, the petty thefts, the murders, especially senior citizens whose children would be abroad. Now, how do we, there was, I'm not really sure, even being from the press, what is the regularity with which the police does patrolling, either day patrolling or night patrolling? So how is the police preemptive of such crimes?
See, the age-old system of beat patrolling is also in existence in Goa. Apart from that, we have got PCR patrolling in day and at night. So patrolling as per the strength available with the Goa police is carried out. But what is lacking is the preventive measures. For example, in Goa, in earlier time, people hardly used grills on their windows and doors, and people didn't even lock their houses. Yeah. But with the rapid urbanization, these things are not possible. There are a lot of strangers who can be in your colony. If you don't lock or secure your house, burglary is possible. And that is what is happening. We have caught a lot of gangs. But again, I would say that it is better to secure your house with small little measures rather than fall prey to such burglaries or house
thefts. Now, in certain cases, you know, recently Prime TV has highlighted one case of a senior citizen, 87-year-old, who was befriended by a caretaker who happened to be staying in the same colony but originally from West Bengal. Now, I am sure you will be aware of this, that this lady has gone missing, and Prime TV said it is a case of kidnapping because 4 lakhs was withdrawn from this. Now, in such cases where, you know, the senior citizens are helpless, they also require help. Now, how does one go about this?
No, this is a very important case you have highlighted. I am aware of this, and I have asked SP North to work in this direction, and we have certain details about the person. We are working on it. But this is a fact that a lot of senior citizens are living alone, and they have to be looked after, and that is why we have got a senior citizen cell which is systematically, we are going to their houses, checking their security preparedness, giving them the telephone number. But at the same time, as I mentioned earlier, suppose this caretaker was there, at least the senior citizen could have informed us that I have employed a caretaker, or I am living with so and so person who is not my blood relative. And this is for your information, this is the photograph.
What we understood was, you know, that there is a old age home which had employed him and supplied, but they did not give a police check to the nearest police station.
See, this is a serious drawback, whether it is related to tenants, whether it is related to employees. Lot of people are working from outside in Goa, business houses, establishment, shacks, restaurants. So proper identification of anyone you are employing, the photograph, the telephone number, the home address, other contact details, his details about his relatives, is a must. And in all such cases, if this information is available, then it is easy to track a person rather than having a name without any photograph or cell phone number or address, and the name may be fictitious.
So this is very, very serious, because, you know, many people are feeling backward to intimate the police, you know, especially when they employ domestics or any other persons of this type. So the police require, you know, this kind of details in order to act on the information in case, you know, something
so
turns.
This is in the interest of the safety. All employees must be photographed, their addresses should be known, and it is the duty of the employer to intimate to the police so that at least we can find out who he is, whether the address is correct, whether he is a criminal background, or whether he should be really employed or not. This is important for safety point of view.
Okay, now, you know, I'll just open this topic because we'll take a short break after a minute or two. You know, similarly, there have been cases where terrorists have come and stayed in parts of Goa in houses even for over a month without being detected. Now, how do you propose to tackle this?
See,
because, you know, the police stations in which they stay, like, for example, Anjuna or Pedne, these are not, you know, like Panjim headquarters or Panjim town police station. They are understaffed. You know, the PI is the person who is in charge. So how do you deal with this?
See, Goa is a tourist destination, and a large number of tourists from India as well as abroad are coming. So there is a system in place that for any hotel or any person who is admitting a guest, the details, the identification is to be taken and intimated to the press. In case of foreigners, there is a form which is to be filled online, and information comes to us automatically. In case you are not taking the name, address and identification of anyone who is living in your house as a guest, then it is a serious failure, and anyone in the garb of a tourist can come to Goa and stay. He could be a criminal in hiding, he could be a terrorist. So therefore this responsibility is upon the citizen and the house owners to intimate to the police. In case they do not do that, there are serious consequences, and they can be arrested on this count for not giving proper information. And my endeavor would be to plug all these loopholes so that no one is able to hide under fictitious name or identity in Goa. Even though this is a huge task and a lot of work requires to be done, but we have to make serious efforts and take those people to task who do not obey this order.
Okay. At this juncture, let us take a short break. We are with Dr. Muktesh Chandar, who has recently taken over as the Director General of Police. We'll be back after a short break. Welcome back to Guest Editor. We are with the new Director General of Police of Goa, Dr. Muktesh Chandar. We are talking about, you know, surveillance and security, and we are talking about Goa being a tourist state and a lot of foreigners and domestic tourists coming to Goa, and the need for keeping a check on people who stay here, whether it is in rented premises or in hotels. Now, Dr. Chandar, you would also agree that Goa has become a hub for drugs and prostitution, because there is no clean tourism as such, because you can't avoid certain elements from coming here. Now, how do you propose to keep a check on the drug trade, for example, for which Goa is being known and projected in the cyber world as a hub where drugs are easily available?
See, there is a problem in coastal belt and other places of drugs. We have been catching these criminals, whether Indians or foreigners. But I believe that a lot of this hype has been created that Goa is a drug hub and a hub for prostitution, which is incorrect. Yes, there are problems which can occur at any place in the country, and the availability of drugs cannot be ruled out in any state. Goa being a tourist destination, this hype or this bad publicity has been there, but I want to reassure everyone that we are very harsh on this drug trade and prostitution. In the after my arrival, we have been very systematically checking all these prostitution dens, particularly these which are available online, and lot of such raids have been conducted. This is a nuisance which keeps occurring again and again.
Let us take that one at a time, in the sense that is the police able to plug the routes through which the drugs come into the state? Because we have the land border on three sides, and there is a sea route. So and the means of transport are by road, basically rail and by air. So is the Goa police able to plug these holes and find out exactly from which side these drugs are coming?
It is as far as the detection is concerned, checking every vehicle at the border without knowing, without having intelligence, does not serve any purpose. And thousands of vehicles are coming and going out of Goa every hour. So without any proper intelligence, it is futile to have to search for drugs or anything.
So the question is,
it is always done by using intelligence. It is always done by detection, by criminal investigation, and that is how we keep catching. And I'm tightening my screws on these drug dealers. I have had a meeting with my officers, and already we have conducted a lot of raids, and you will see results in future.
Now, do you have an interstate police network which actually shares information about people who are moving? Do you have a list of people who are operating across the state? Because you know these links are also international, in the sense that Pakistan would not be out of this list, Malaysia would not be out of this list.
We are in touch with the intelligence agencies and our counterparts in adjoining states and districts. Without intelligence, it is difficult to work. So we are strengthening our intelligence equipment also, and we will see the results very soon.
Now, why we express this sense of concern? Because you know earlier it was limited to the tourist belt and to the coast. But you know in the recent past, for example, in these EDMs, there have already been two deaths related to drugs or suspected drug abuse and overdose. Not only that, but even in the interiors for birthday parties, as it is done in Bombay or this kind of metropolises, you find in Kurtori there was the death of youth at a birthday party where drugs were served. Now Kurtori, you would well understand, is much in the interior. Forget about school dropouts in Kalangut, Bardes belt. But this has now infiltrated into families. It is not to traffickers and to drug addicts, that kind of a community, or truck drivers, for example.
No, as I mentioned, we are working on it, and very seriously. There would be zero tolerance for any drug traffic or prostitution or any other organized crime.
Okay, now coming to this twin kind of serious problems, there are cases where in the past there has been a police politician drug mafia nexus, as it was called by the press at that time, seriously highlighted. The fingers were pointed to the past home minister himself. There was a death of a British teenager which was linked to overdose of drugs, and that case is still pending, and it has brought international shame to Goa. How do you propose to tackle when there are big sharks involved in this?
See, when the investigation throws up any big name or anyone for that matter, the law must take its own course, and any nexus of any sort has to be broken. It has to be dealt with very severely, and I am very clear about it.
Now, just to for the information of the public, because the public would have a bad perception about the police, just to clear the air, very often there are police officers or constables who are suspended and inquiries are held. But even in this case, the cynicism with the public is such that they say after 2 years, the police officers who are involved or alleged to be involved in this, they have joined work.
I cannot comment anything on the past, but I would ask all the viewers through Prime TV that if you see any organized crime, if you see any drug nexus, if you see any prostitution going on, come forward. I promise you that I will take action, and here is an opportunity to come forward and raise your voice against anything illegal going on in Goa.
Now, in the case of this political related crimes, Goa, being a small state, has some advantages and also some disadvantages, in the sense that because it is a small state, it is very easy, or we perceive that it is easy to interfere with the police functioning. The people in power, the business families who are connected to politics, there is a perception that they can get away with crime because FIRs are not registered against MLAs or ministers, even when there are serious allegations of crimes against women. How do you propose to tackle this?
See, as far as the investigation and detection work of police is concerned, police is accountable to law of the land and to the judiciary, and there are other several institutions which oversee the functioning of the police. So there is no escape if police tries to do anything wrong or tries to get influenced by any kind of extraneous pressure.
But my question is, how do you play it? Because
one has to work only according to the law, and that is what I am going to ensure. If there is any kind of softness leniency because of certain extraneous factor, then I'm going to
but deal but with you would have known seriously. You would have known that, you know, Indian politician basically they tried to, you know, put pressure on the police. It's not only in Goa but also in other parts. Where is the space for the honest officers? Because even in Goa, you know, when in the city itself there was a police senior police officer who cracked down on prostitution. I mean, of course, he committed a mistake by slapping the person concerned because he took some political names that I will teach you a lesson. But he was, you know, shunted out of Goa. The person is no longer with police or with Goa police. So where is the space for honest officers? No,
no. There is always a space for honest and sincere officers. I have believed it all my life, throughout my career, and I have never faced any kind of political interference. If you stand by the law will take care of everything.
Okay, now, you know, since you are at the beginning of your innings, what is your plan in terms of, you know, boosting the morale of the police, the prestige of the Goa police, you know, because, you know, you have certain, you know, police units, crack units, like Mumbai police, for example, or, you know, the Metropolitan Police in UK, the London Police or the New York Police, you know, just to belong to the police is a great thing. So, you know, how do you propose, like, for example, your trainees in Walpoi Police Training College, or, you know, the constable, because, you know, they also require a lot of support because they are the people on the job day in and day out, braving the sun and the rain. They are the people who encounter the citizens directly. So how do you propose to boost their morale and, you know, give them that confidence that, you know, here is a director general of police who is counting on us, who is trusting us, who is with us, and because they also have a lot of problems in terms of the living quarters, in terms of their salaries, in terms of the living conditions.
See, the respect in the eyes of the public can be earned only by sincere work, impartial work, and efficient work. The police community relationship has to be strengthened. Of course, there is a lot of need to have the capacity building within the police force also. We have got training school, very, very rudimentary sort of this thing. So a lot of training has to be imparted using training institutes of other states and specialized training courses available to us. And the morale boosting is possible when we work as per the command of the law, without any bias, without any fear, without any interference. And this is what I am going to ensure, that this confidence is there within the every policeman, that if they stand by the law will protect, the seniors will protect, and they will not tolerate any kind of interference from any quarter.
And one of the key elements of improving their morale would be to increase and you know, facilitate their competencies. Because, you know, policing is no longer common sense that, you know, you catch the lawbreaker and then, you know, take the necessary
action. You're right, absolutely right. A lot of advances.
How to tackle, for example, a mob? How to tackle a citizen who is very angry? How to tackle a motorist, for example? Because, as you mentioned rightly, that there are a lot of deaths related to this. Now, how does a policeman have those human skills? How does he have your technical policing skills, you know, in order to boost his morale?
That is what is capacity building. For everything, there are specialized courses, and my endeavor would be to send as many people as possible for these specialized
courses training,
so that the policing aspects are improved. They learn the latest in the in terms of technology and policing about using modern methods. And every slot, training slot made available to us would be utilized.
Okay. Dr. Muktesh Chandran, my last question to you is, in terms of this police community kind of, you know, confidence and you know trust in the police. Now, you know, you would have known the recent incidents that have been, there have been a few incidents in Goa where there have been lathi charges. The previous one was the Bismarck, you know, agitation just here outside your police headquarters. Similarly, the previous one of the agitating local traditional fishermen, the Ramponkars. Now, you know, when the public sees visuals of this type, that the police, you know, especially the Panjim police station, you know, they are out with their lathis against the police, and on the other hand, the chief minister inaugurates community policing or little police. Now, how do the people, live with this kind of, how do you put together these images that the police is somebody that we can trust?
See, one important thing I want to mention here is that peaceful agitation or protest is right of everyone in democracy. But that should not be extended to the protest can be done anywhere and it can be unlawful or you can block traffic. Now, for example, in this particular case, the agitation took place without any permission at a place where it was not supposed to. The traffic was blocked and as per reports, some of our policemen were also assaulted.
Yeah.
In such a situation, obviously police has to take action and that is what it did. If the same agitation was at Azad Maidan, peaceful agitation, there was no need for police to do anything. One can agitate as long as they want. And in here also in this particular case, the agitation was going on for 2 days and still police did not intervene, whereas the agitation was unlawful.
Okay.
So the peaceful agitation should never be mixed with the taking law in your own hands in the name of agitation.
Okay.
However serious the grievance could be, but still there are peaceful protest avenues available.
Okay, Dr. Muktesh Chandar, we thank you for talking to Prime, and we wish you all the best in the years ahead in Goa.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you.
That was Dr. Muktesh Chandar, the Director General of Police. He has expressed his views about improving the security and surveillance. He has sent out a word of caution to citizens who are letting out their premises to improve the security and to help the police. He's also said that he will not tolerate any kind of interference and the law of the land will be supreme. He's also sent out a word of caution to the agitators that you should not take law into their hands and agitate peacefully. We hope that you enjoyed this edition of Guest Editor. Keep watching Prime TV.